Two former American vessels carrying nearly 4,000 Jewish refugees arrive at the port of Haifa, Palestine. Jammed like cattle on the rusty craft, the fugitives end their bleak voyage, which began at a Black Sea port. The death of an infant was first blamed on British tear gas, but examination showed it was accidentally crushed and suffocated on the overcrowded ship. All precautions are taken to prevent the spread of disease as small children debark along with fathers and mothers, all showing the signs of fatigue and illness. The British encounter little trouble transferring the refugees. Mostly the procedure is carried out in an orderly manner as embarkation for Cyprus detention camps takes place. Cyprus, already bursting with refugees, is preferable to deportation to Europe as had been threatened. At Lake Success, New York, the United Nations gives Palestine's problems first consideration. Herschel Johnson, U.S. delegate, backs partition in a message to the Assembly's Special Palestine Committee.
The United States delegation supports the basic principles of the unanimous recommendations and the majority plan which provides for partition and immigration. We refer to assistance through the United Nations in meeting economic and financial problems and the problem of internal law and order during the transition period. The latter problem might require the establishment of a special constabulary or police force recruited on a volunteer basis by the United Nations.
Later, Russia supported the United States on the partition recommendation, while Arab states threatened reprisals, as the Holy Land's future hangs in the balance.